When Giriraj Maharaj, he came to India, you know, especially after seeing Srinathji Prabhu and Mahaprabhu sitting here, I was reminded that Srila Prabhupada, he was attracting all these young American boys and girls. And Giriraj Maharaj's father, he came and he was arguing with Prabhupada that, you give my son back and I'll give you a blank check. Whatever amount you need, you take it, but give my son back. And Giriraj Maharaj whispered in Prabhupada's ear, keep the check and keep me also. And Prabhupada said, no. He talked to his father very nicely and he was saying that your son is making his own free choice. So Giriraj Maharaj's mother, she was very concerned and she started telling Prabhupada that my son is losing weight, he's not keeping good health. And Prabhupada immediately called some devotees and said, bring some rasgulla and sandesh and, you know, and then he brought right in front of his mother and said, I promise you that we will give him every day at least half a kilo of this. And then his father, you know, he said, my son tells me that when it is hot in India, you go to America. When it is cold in America, you come to India. That's very intelligent of you. Prabhupada said, your son, he observed this and he's come to this conclusion, so he's very intelligent. And because he's your son, you have to be very intelligent. So Giriraj Maharaj's father, he commented to Giriraj Maharaj that, I can say two things about your spiritual master and why he has been successful in establishing Krishna consciousness all over the world. First, he is a great organizer. Because without being an organizer, you cannot have a movement organized all over the world. And secondly, he knows how to deal with people. And therefore, Srila Prabhupada had these five qualities which really made him extremely successful as a leader. First, he was humble. Second, he was extremely enthusiastic. So this is a very powerful combination of having terrific enthusiasm and humility. And then thirdly, Srila Prabhupada appreciated all the devotees and their contributions. Then fourthly, Srila Prabhupada recognized devotees who performed with excellence. He gave special recognition to excellence. And fifthly, Srila Prabhupada gave devotees creative freedom and allowed them to experiment in different ways. And therefore we find that the way Srila Prabhupada established Krishna consciousness all over the world, Sripad Ramanujacharya, and in the Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya there is one scripture called Prapannamrita Tapan. And in that there are five symptoms given of who can be called as a founder acharya. So there are many acharyas, but what is the difference between acharya and a founder acharya? So it is described that the founder acharya is someone who is uddharaka and upakarika, one who does good for others and one who is delivering the others with his message. Secondly, it is described a founder acharya is dina bhaya, one who awards fearlessness. Thirdly, a founder acharya is someone who gives details, commentaries of the Vaishnava scriptures. And Srila Prabhupada presented those commentaries in the English language so that all of us could understand. Otherwise, it was impossible to understand in Sanskrit for majority of the people across the world. And fourthly, a founder acharya also comments and explains and elucidates all of the songs of the Vaishnava acharyas and explains about them. And fifthly, a founder acharya, he is so synonymous with the parampara and the line which he is starting in a certain way that he becomes extremely important personality in that sampradaya or parampara, and practically speaking, people in that line they refer to the philosophy by his name. So we say that we are following Srila Prabhupada. By Prabhupada's grace we are, you know, understanding all of these scriptures. So the very essence of the scriptures and the conclusions become very closely connected with this personality. Someone asked Srila Prabhupada, "Have you seen God?" So Prabhupada said, "If you don't know what is gold, and I show you any metal, then how will you know whether it is gold or not?" So therefore, if you ask, "Have you seen gold?" and you have not seen gold, you do not even know how to identify what is gold, what is not gold. So therefore, if you are asking me, "Have you seen God?" so my question is, do you know who is God? Do you know how to see God? Do you know the form about God? Do you know all the details about God? He said, "No." So Prabhupada said, "In that case, since you don't know, whatever I say, you have to accept it." So he says, "Okay, I will accept." So Prabhupada said, "Then I say, I have seen God." So Srila Prabhupada, he established Krishna consciousness movement in a very solid way, not just on the basis of philosophy, but whoever interacted with him could experience tangibly that here is a person who is experiencing the presence of Krishna. And therefore, Prabhupada's personality and presence was the ultimate answer to all skepticism, all doubts, all other kinds of contradictions. And therefore, in the first 50 years, ISKCON has progressed a lot and we have gone through various challenges. Moving into the future, unless and until the movement is able to inspire devotees who actually have this kind of a tangible experience, it's going to become extremely difficult to defy the various kinds of skepticism, whether the process works or not. So therefore, the real answer to most of the doubts will come when the devotees who are connected to this movement, and when Prabhupada was there, 90% of ISKCON was living in the temples. Today the statistics is exactly reversed. 95% of ISKCON is living in the homes and only 5% is living in the temples. And therefore, the entire paradigm has to be redefined as to how do we inspire people all across the world living in all of these situations to actually experience Krishna consciousness in a tangible way, where they see Krishna consciousness solving the real life problems of their life and giving them a tangible, substantial, internal, enlivening and enlightening experience. And when this happens, then more and more devotees will automatically embrace Krishna consciousness more seriously, with more commitment, and also feel inspired to share Krishna consciousness with others. So on this momentous occasion of the 50th anniversary of the movement, I would like to pray at the lotus feet of Srila Prabhupada that he gives us the strength to progress into the future generations with a small semblance of the conviction and fearlessness which he carried. Someone asked Srila Prabhupada, you know, he was arguing, "I am fearless, I am God. What do you say?" Prabhupada said, "When there is a traffic signal, do you stop or not? Do you stop at the red light?" He said, "Yes." Prabhupada, "That means you are fearful." So you cannot claim that you are fearless. So therefore, Prabhupada's name is Abhay Charanarvind Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, that the ultimate fearlessness comes when there is a tangible experience of Krishna consciousness. And without the grace of great souls and Srila Prabhupada's blessings, it is not possible. So let us pray for this experience. Thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.